Yeah, this is Man Verse Music. Ah, you know what I'm saying? Michael Eiffel in the building, you know what I'm saying? We're gonna do it like this. It ain't flavor, it's fever.
Niggas got penny on the wall. I'm on that. Niggas got phony on the wall. I'm on that. I'm on that.
What's going on, world? I'm Wesley from A Connection TV, the network, the one channel on YouTube where we actually adopt similar connections despite our differences. And I'm here to adopt similar connections despite my sensitive ass differences. Fucking the challenge. We're watching the channel. I'm watching the challenge right now. I'm going to do the same kind of format. Not all the time, goddammit. But I'm going to do the same kind of format with that I do with the real world with the challenge. And, CT is worried about freaking DM. It got me going crazy watching this shit because CT automatically explodes when he finds out that DM was rushed to the hospital. And the producers don't want to take him to the hospital because CT is drinking. And they've dealt with CT before and in this drinking ways, and they just want to calm him down and keep him. CT was ready to whoop all their ass. Oh man, but you could tell. CT, everybody was like, CT, you're right. Leave me alone. Leave me alone. I don't want to talk about it. Leave me alone. I'm like, yo, CT cares. Oh my God, I could just imagine what this dude just. Wow. This is why CT wasn't on We Love DM, the special, because there's no way that this dude can comment on DM. There's no way you could say, you could. I was just like, oh man, this is crazy. Which, by the way, We Love DM was just, I loved it. I mean, We Love DM. I freaking love it. Like, it was awesome, but it's great to see the reality in reality TV. And although this is a crazy and just sad situation, you connect. You definitely connect. And when he made the little, oh, DM comes in, talks about, you know, we gotta definitely talk about this, because she's talking about at the hospital, knowing damn well she wasn't at the hospital. That little thing that he was doing in the post-confessional, and then he just turns and smiles with his bright teeth, like, yo, is shit like this is the reason why I watch reality TV, for real. Real World, The Challenge, like, this is reality TV to me. So this freaking sucks because DM has to go home because she's sick, and we all know what happens after that. The look on CT's face is crazy, and we don't know what happens after that because he's off the show. They tell him that he can no longer be on the show because DM is leaving and he doesn't have a partner. This is all bittersweet. This is just bitter, not even sweet. It's just bitter because anyways, like, it's whatever. So now I'm about to watch the first challenge, and I'm kind of like not even in the mood. Like, I'm really not. Sour patches, the only candy to have. If you have sour patches, or if you get me sour patches, is the way for me to fall in love with you, or to get over me being angry with you. So, sour patches. So yeah, not really a whole lot going on in this particular challenge. They do the rope thing, dangling from the thing, and they fall in the water, and they gotta swim to the buoy and kick the bell. This seems repetitive. I've seen this before, at least something like this. So I'm like, oh, whatever. So the two finalists, as far as teams are concerned, is Wes and Teresa and Sarah and Jordan. I'm happy that Sarah and Jordan won. I'm a fan. Well, not a fan, but I'm a supporter of Sarah and Jordan. Sarah's been on 8 challenges, hasn't won one yet. Jordan is very, very cocky, but because of his one hand having self, I am so motivated and inspired by him because he still does every freaking challenge like he has 8 hands. You know what I'm saying? So I like Jordan. And the whole Jordan and Marlon duo, I'm all here for it. So I don't know how I feel about Sarah manipulating Wes and Bananas, although they've done it to everyone else. It's weird because it's like two wrongs does not make it right, two negatives doesn't create a positive, and so that's kind of like how I feel. I feel Sarah has gone through all 8 challenges being so nice and so great, Well, it really hasn't helped her, I guess, so that's probably why she's decided to switch it up, but it's just weird. Jordan, not so much, because, I mean, I don't understand Jordan doing it, but Shara, I don't know. But she really has the two teams thinking that they're allies. Interesting. So, it's Brittany and Adam, I think is his name. I don't know. And Simone and her guy or whatever, and they're doing this eating challenge. I'm so disconnected at this point because I'm just still thinking about CT and DM. That's truth be told. I'm just thinking about them. And then when TJ said that another team was going to come out during the challenge, I kind of got excited because I want to see another team come out. But he's like, no, I'm not introducing another team. And there still is going to be a challenge. I'm like, oh, okay, whatever. But anyways, Simone calls for Brittany's partner to eat 7 brownies. First of all, Simone went, Brittany said I have 4, and then Simone said 3. So I'm like, what is going on? But anyways, the dude comes out and he eats the 7 brownies. Like, I could eat 7 brownies. Like, milk, it's brownies. I don't know what the fuck a yucca stick is, but the dude dares Brittany to eat 13 or 14 yucca sticks. I don't know what the hell that shit is. She says it's like a French fry, but it's dry and ugh, whatever. It looked like potato wedges to me. I could eat 13 potato wedges in 3 minutes. And so now we're at a point where there's a different thing for them to eat. And of course, everybody's gasping like, So I wonder what they have to eat now. So, Simone and her dude get sent home because he can't eat 11 patacones. And to be quite honest, this challenge was the dumbest fucking challenge ever. Like, it was dumb. I don't know if y'all really like this particular episode. I could care less. I mean, quite frankly, now that CT and DM's not, I mean, who else is the power couple? Jordan, Sarah, Naya, and Leroy. I mean, I like looking at Zach. Wes and Teresa, I like Wes. So, I mean, whatever. Deuces.
Yeah, this is Man Verse Music. You know what I'm saying? Michael Eichfield in the building, you know what I'm saying? We're gonna do it like this. It ain't flavor, it's fever. Niggas got penny on the wall. I'm on that. Niggas got phony on the low. I'm on that. I'm on that.